Hello children, how are you doing? Hope all are doing good and safe. Today's lesson is Dear Departed, 10th class, 2nd unit, A reading and B reading. Dear Departed, this is a one act play. One act means completes in one scene or in one place. That is the scene place is one area. What are the characters? Let us see. Mrs. Amelia Slater, Mrs. Elizabeth Jordan. These two are sisters. Husbands of Amelia and Elizabeth. Henry Slater is the husband of Amelia and Ben Jordan is the husband of Elizabeth Jordan. So these two are one couple and these two are another couple. These sisters' father's name is Abel Meriwether, father of Amelia and Elizabeth. And this Slater has one daughter named Victoria Slater, a girl of 10, Amelia's daughter. Okay. One wife and husband, another wife and husband, these two women's father, Abel Meriwether, and one small kid, 10 years girl, Victoria. The play starts with Mrs. Slater's dialogue saying, "Victoria, Victoria, do you hear? Come in, will you? Will you?" Victoria comes in. Mrs. Slater, "I am amazed at you, Victoria. I really am. Be off now and change your dress before your Aunt Elizabeth and your Uncle Ben come. It would never do for them to find you in colors with Grandfather lying dead upstairs." So, who is calling? Mrs. Slater is calling Victoria. And what she is asking? She is asking to change the dress. Who are coming? Yes, Aunt Elizabeth and your Uncle Ben. Whose aunt and uncle? Victoria's aunt Elizabeth and Uncle Ben are coming. Why they are coming? Because Grandfather was lying dead. Because my grandfather died and he was on the upstairs. Victoria, what are they coming? They haven't been here for ages. Why they are coming, ma'am? Asked Victoria. Mrs. Slater, they are coming to talk over the poor grandpa's affair. Your father sent them a telegram as soon as we found he was dead. A noise is heard. We found that your grandfather died. So your father sent a telegram. On seeing the telegram, they will come immediately. Henry Slater, what is the personality of Henry Slater? Henry Slater, a stooping heavy man with a drooping mustache, enters. He is wearing a black tail coat, grey trousers, a black tie and a bowler's hat. This is the structure of or posture of Henry Slater, who is the husband of Mrs. Slater. Okay, let us see here. Victoria, Victoria, do you hear? Come in, will you? Mrs. Slater is calling Victoria to come in and change the dress because the visitors may come at any time. Why they are coming? Because grandpa died and he was on the upstairs. Henry, I'm wondering if they will come at all. When you and Elizabeth quarreled, she said she would never set foot in your house again. Henry asking, Amelia, will they come? She said, I won't come to your house again. When you quarrel, no. మీరు ఇద్దరు పోట్లాడుకున్న తర్వాత అసలు నేను రాను పో అని చెప్పింది కదా, వస్తాదంటావా అంటే మిసెస్ స్లేటర్ అంటుంది. షీ విల్ కమ్ ఫాస్ట్ ఎనఫ్ ఆఫ్టర్ హర్ షేప్ ఆఫ్ వాట్ అవర్ ఫాదర్స్ లెఫ్ట్. యు నో హౌ హార్డ్ షీ హ్యాస్ బీన్ వెన్ షీ లైక్స్ విత్ వేర్ షీ గెట్స్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఐ కాంట్ టెల్. డెఫినెట్లీ షీ విల్ కమ్ బికాస్ షీ వాంట్ టు టేక్ హర్ షేర్ ఇన్ my in our father's property. Henry, I suppose it's in the family pass. Where are my slippers? Okay. What about my slippers? I can't find my slippers. Where are my slippers? Mrs. Slater said, "It in the kitchen." But you want a new pair? Those old ones are nearly worn out. Oh, those slippers are really worn out. I will give you a new pair. Nearly breaking down. You don't seem to realize what is costing me. Bear-like I am doing. My heart's fit to break when I see the little trifle that belong to father lying around. I think I never use them again. Basically, you had better wear those slippers of my father's now. It's lucky. Your slippers are already worn out, so you can use my father's slippers as he is already dead. You can take my father's slippers. He had just got a new pair. At the same time, he also he just purchased a new pair of slippers. You can use them, Mrs. Slater said to her husband. Henry, they will be very small for me, my dear. Oh, they will be very small for me. They won't fit for me, said Henry. Mrs. Slater, then I will stretch, won't they? They will stretch, no? If you stretch them, what in Sagadi sir and Kondi Saripotundi Gada? I'm not going to have them wasted. She has finished laying the table. Henry, I have been thinking about the bureau of my father's that is in the bedroom. You know, I always wanted to have it after he died. Okay, I will stretch it. You take that slippers. Of course, my dear husband, my father has a bureau on the upstairs. Always I wanted that bureau. Of course he died. Why can't we move that bureau to our flat? Then he said, Henry, you must arrange with Elizabeth when you are dividing things up. Alantappudu meeriddaru divide chesukuntunnappudu bureau naaku kavali ani cheppu adugu annanu. Mrs. Slater, Elizabeth, that sharp, she will see I am after it, and we will drive a hard bargain over it. No, she won't obey like that, because she is also interested in that bureau. So we need to bargain a lot. Mantam chala baran cheyal chostademo, maybe ivademo an. And perhaps she has got her eye on the bureau as well. Avunu tanaki kuda bureau meeda aalochana undi anukuntu. Mrs. Slater, she is Slater. They all stretch, won't they? I am not going to have them wasted on bureaus as well. She has never been there since father bought it. Avunu kani ma father bureau konna tarvata Elizabeth asli ikkadiki raledu. She never been here. She means here? Yes, Elizabeth never been here since father bought it. Nana konna tarvata avadi inta varaku raledu. If it was only down here instead of his room, she had never guessed it was our own. Adi ganaka kinda undanuko, it belongs to us antan anukuntundi, idi manade anukuntundi kada anandi. Startled, Amelia. Henry surprised. What, Amelia, nuvu enta telivigala danivi anukuntu. Mrs. Slater, Henry, why should not we bring that bureau down here now? We can do it before they come. Manam aa bureau ni kindaku teeskochcheyochu kada ippude vaallu vachche lopuna. Why can't we shift that bureau to the downstairs before they come? Asked who is she? Mrs. Slater. Then stupefied, I won't care to. Don't look so daft. Do you want to see the bureau? Yes, you can see the bureau here. This is the image of bureau. For that, they are fighting. Okay. I am wondering if they come at all. When you and Elizabeth quarreled, she said she had never set foot over. In the previous dialogue, Henry asked, "Meeriddaru potladukunnaru kada, will she come back? Will she come to your house again?" I am wondering if they will come at all when you and Elizabeth quarreled, she said. She had never set foot in your house again. In Malli, me intlo ki raanu anandu kada ani Henry gurtu chestunte. She will come fast enough after her share of what our fathers left. You know how hard she can be when she likes where she gets from it all, said the said Mrs. Amelia. Henry, stupefied. I would not care to. Mrs. Slater, don't look so daft. Why not? It doesn't seem delicate somehow. Mrs. Slater, we should put that shabby old chest of drawers upstairs where the bureau is now. Will it happen? Mana teesukuragalama ante em parvaledu manam bureau kindaku techesi man daggara unna chetta box undi kada obi old shabby chest. Chest means box. A box teesukeli akkada petteddamu anandi. Elizabeth could have that and welcome. I have always wanted to get rid of it. Naaku eppati nuncho aa paata box bayata bareyalanundi adu akkada petteddamu haayiga untundi ani cheppesindi Mrs. Slater. And suppose they come when we are doing it? Okavela manam aa pani chestu unnappudu vaallu vasteno? I will fasten the front door. Get your coat off, Henry. We will change it. Mrs. Slater goes out to fasten the front door. Henry takes his coat off. Mrs. Slater reappears. Nu coat these pakkan pettu. In meantime lo nenu elli bayata talipesi vastanu. If they come within which that time we can shift the bureau from upstairs to downstairs. Meantime, Mrs. Slater appears. Mrs. Slater, I will run up and move the chairs out of the way. Adarlo unna kurchilani pakkaku jaripestanu. Victoria appears dressed according to her mother's instructions. Intaloki evaru vastaru? Victoria changed her dress and came to the dais. Victoria, what have you got your coat off, father? Henry, mother and I are going to bring grandfather's bureau down here. Daddy, why you take off the coat? Enduku nu coat teesesavu ante, we are going to shift the bureau from grandfather's house to grandfather's flat to our flat. Are you planning to pinch it? Meer pinch ayipothunnara, dongatanam cheyipothunnara anangane Henry anna. Henry shocked. Are you going to pinch an anangane? No, no, no. Are you planning to pinch it? Shocked. No, my child. Grandpa gave it to your mother before he died. No, no, no. Adem jaragaledu. Grandpa ichadu memma chanipoye mundu memmaki ichadu ani cheppi annadu Henry. This morning, ivala poddun ichada. Henry, yes. Victoria, he was drunk this morning. Mrs. Slater appears carrying a handsome clock under her arm. Victoria is speaking with her father. Oh, Henry said that grandpa presented that bureau to your mother, said Henry. Oh, said Victoria. Meanwhile, ee madhyalo em jarigindante, Mrs. Slater appears carrying a handsome clock under her arm. Pai nunchi chase jarapadaniki vellina manchi, Mrs. Slater em chesindi, oka clock pattukoni kindaku digutundi. Clock means this. This is a clock. Watch lantadu anamata, pedda watch lantadu. Teesukoni kindaku digutundi. Mrs. Slater, I thought I had fetched this down as well. She puts it on the mantelpiece. Our clock's worth nothing and this always appealed to me. Idi chala baagundi kada, naaku eppadi nuncho deeni meeda aas undi, teesukochesanu adigo chudandi. Mrs. Slater is fetching a clock from upstairs to downstairs while Victoria and Henry are talking about bureau. Be quiet, it's our own now. Come, Henry, lift other end. At the same time, and they shifted the bureau also. Henry and Mrs. Slater, very hot and flushed, stagger it with a pretty old-fashioned bureau containing a locked desk. They put it where the chest of dryers was and the straightened the ornaments etc. There is a knock at the door. The knocking is repeated. Victoria ushers in Ben and Mrs. Jordan. The latter is a stout, complexed woman with an irritating air of being always right. She is wearing an outfit of new mourning. Ben is also a complete new mourning. He is rather a jolly little man, but at present trying to adapt himself to the regrettable occasion. Mrs. Jordan sails into the room and solemnly goes straight to Mrs. Slater and kisses her. The men shake hands. So, meanwhile, when they just shifted bureau, at that time, there is a knock on the door. That is, the visitors, the village, Elizabeth and Ben came there. How are they? Elizabeth is a fat woman and Ben is a small little man with a smile on his face, but now he is pretending that is Nadu, sadness on his face. Mrs. Jordan, well, Amelia, and so he has gone at last. Atlaithe emi mottaniki chanipoyadu anamata anandi Mrs. Jordan. Mrs. Slater, yes, he has gone. He was 72 a fortnight last Sunday. She sniffs back a tear. Avunu ippudiki 74 years 72 years vachindi vayasu ayipoyindi kada. He చనిపోయాడు అని చెప్పి చెప్పింది. ఎవరు చనిపోయింది? ఎవరు? అబెల్ మేరీ వెదర్. బెన్ చూప్లీ, నౌ అమేలియా, యూ మస్ట్ నాట్ గివ్ అవే. వీ హావ్ ఆల్ గాట్ టు డై సమ్ టైమ్ ఆర్ అదర్. ఏ డోంట్ క్రై సమ్ ఆర్ అదర్ డే. ఎవ్రీ డే షుడ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ షుడ్ డై. డోంట్ క్రై, సెడ్ బెన్ టు అమేలియా. మిస్సెస్ జోర్డాన్, and now perhaps you will tell us about it. Ela jarigindi ento cheptava ani adigithe Mrs. Slater cheptundi. Father had been merry this morning. He went out soon after breakfast to pay his insurance. Baane unnadu poddan varaku kuda santoshanga unnadu. Poddan insurance kadataniki velli kuda baane unnadu. After breakfast insurance kadataniki vellaadu ante Ben antadu, my word, it's good thing he did. Aha, chanipoye mundu insurance kuda kattada, manchi manchi pani chesadu. Mrs. Jordan, he always was thoughtful in that way. He was too honorable to have gone without paying his premium. He is a very good person. My father is a very good person. He knows his duties. So before dying, he paid the premium also. Praised her father, Henry. And when I came in, I found him undressed sure enough and snug in బెడ్. నేను ఇంటికి వచ్చేసరికి అతను డ్రెస్ మార్చుకొని పడుకొని ఉండిపోయాడు. మిస్సెస్ స్లేటర్, అండ్ వెన్ వీ హ్యాడ్ ఫినిష్డ్ డిన్నర్, ఐ థాట్ ఐ వుడ్ టేక్ అప్ అ బిట్ ఆఫ్ సంథింగ్ ఆన్ ఎ ట్రే. హీ వాజ్ లయింగ్ దేర్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ద వరల్డ్ యాజ్ ఇఫ్ హీ వాజ్ అస్లీప్. సో ఐ పుట్ ద ట్రే డౌన్ ఆన్ ద బ్యూరో, కరెక్టింగ్ హర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఆన్ ద చెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద డ్రయర్స్ అండ్ వెంట్ టు వేకెన్ హిమ్ ఎ పాస్. హీ వాజ్ క్వైట్ కోల్డ్. డిన్నర్ అయిపోయిన తర్వాత అతనికి ఏమైనా ఇద్దాము, సమ్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ ఏదైనా కాఫీ కానీ టీ కానీ ఇద్దామని చెప్పేసి నేను వెళ్ళాను. వెళ్ళేసరికి దెర్ ఈస్ నో మూమెంట్ ఇన్ హిజ్ బాడీ. హీ వాజ్ ఆల్రెడీ కోల్డ్, చల్లగా అయిపోయాడు. అందుకని చెప్పి నేను ట్రేని ఐ కెప్ ద ట్రే అన్ ద బ్యూరో, బ్యూరో మీద పెట్టాను అని వెంటనే సర్దుకొని నోనో అన్ ద చెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ డ్రాయర్స్, అక్కడ ఉన్న టేబుల్ మీద పెట్టాను అని చెప్పి చెప్పింది. ఎందుకు? ఆల్రెడీ బ్యూరోని దొంగతనం చేసింది కదా, అందుకని. A pass wipe their eyes and sniffs back tears. Kallampadi neelu ochinattu tuduchukunnattu show chesindi. Mrs. Slater, rising briskly at length in a business like tone, well, will you go up and look at him now? Shall we have tea? Mrs. Slater antundi, sare paiki velli chusoddama, tea daagi veldama akkadiki nana daggariki ante. Mrs. Jordan, what do you say, Ben? Vaalla ayina adigindi, Ben em cheddamo, tea daagudama mundu పైకి వెళ్ళి చూద్దామా అన్ని అంటే, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ పర్టిక్యులర్, ఏదైనా పర్వాలేదు అన్నాడు. మిస్సెస్ జోర్డాన్ సర్వేయింగ్ ద టేబుల్, వెల్ దెన్ ఇఫ్ ద కెటిల్ ఈస్ రెడీ వీ మే యాజ్ వెల్ హ్యావ్ టీ ఫస్ట్. మిస్సెస్ స్లేటర్ పాజెస్. మిస్సెస్ స్లేటర్ Shall we have? Mrs. Slater puts the kettle on the fire and gets tea ready. If tea kettle is ready, we will have tea first, said Mrs. Jordan. Okay, okay. Ani evaru Mrs. Slater tea టీ రెడీ చేస్తానికి కెటిల్ పెట్టింది. వన్ థింగ్ వి మే యాజ్ వెల్ డిసైడ్ నౌ ఈజ్ ద అనౌన్స్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద పేపర్స్. మనం అనౌన్స్ చేయాలి ఇలా చనిపోయాడు అని చెప్పి అన్నాడు హెన్రీ. మిస్సెస్ జోర్డాన్, ఐ వాస్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ దట్. వాట్ వుడ్ యు పుట్ ఎ పాజ్, ఏమని చెప్దాము, ఏమని అనౌన్స్ చేద్దాము అని చెప్పి అన్నాడు బెన్. మిస్సెస్ జోర్డాన్, వెల్ వీ విల్ థింక్ అబౌట్ ఆఫ్టర్ టీ అండ్ దెన్ వీ విల్ లుక్ through the, his bits of things and make a list of them. There is all the furniture in his room. Mrs. Jordan antundi emani tea chesin tea tagin tarvata we will list out the things of our dad and we will divide the property into two parts. Henry is saying there is no jewelry or valuable of that sort. Anta pedda nagalu natra emi levu ani cheptunnadu Amelia vaalla aina Henry. Mrs. Jordan, except his gold watch, he promised that to our Jimmy. Yes, he has a jewelry, that is gold watch. He promised I will give that gold watch to your son Jimmy. Who is Jimmy? Jimmy is the son of Ben Jordan, that is Elizabeth's son. Mrs. Slater promised River Jimmy. I have never heard of that. Avuna promise chesada nenu eppudu inlede and Mrs. Slater. Mrs. Jordan, oh, but he did, Amelia. When he was living with us, he was very fond of Jimmy. Oh, you don't you know, when our father is living with us, he promised that I will give my gold watch to you, my dear Jimmy, like that. Mrs. Slater, well, amazed, I don't know, avuna ala jarigindha ani surprise chesindi. Antaloki Ben antnadu, anyhow there is an insurance money. Have you got the receipt for the premium he paid this morning? Vaadu poddunu kattina insurance amount ki premium ki receipt unda, ponile aa amount anna undi kada annadu inkokallu evaru Ben. Mrs. Slater, I have not seen it. Victoria jumps up from the sofa and comes behind the table. లేదే నేను చూడలేదే, ఇవాళ రిసీటా నేను చూడలేదే అంటే విక్టోరియా అంటుంది ఆ పక్కనున్న సోఫాలోంచి పక్కకు వచ్చి చెప్తుంది. మదర్, ఐ డోంట్ థింక్ గ్రాండ్ ఫా వెంట్ టు పే హిస్ ప్రీమియం దిస్ మార్నింగ్. ఇవాళ మార్నింగ్ వెళ్ళాడు కానీ తాతయ్య, గ్రాండ్ ఫా వెంట్ అవుట్ సైడ్ బట్ హి డిడ్ంట్ పే premium, I think, mummy, said Victoria. Mrs. Slater, he went out, bayt kelladu kada. Yes, but he did not go into the town. He met old Mr. Tattersall down the street and they went off past St. Philip's Church. వెళ్ళాడు కానీ అక్కడ ఉన్న ఓల్డ్ టాటర్సాల్ని కలిసి, మిస్టర్ టాటర్సాల్ని కలిసి అక్కడి నుంచి సెయింట్ ఫిలిప్ చర్చ్కి వెళ్ళారు కానీ ఇన్సూరెన్స్ ఆఫీస్కి వెళ్ళలేదు అని ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఇచ్చింది విక్టోరియా. సో తాతగారు ఎక్కడికి వెళ్ళారు, మిస్టర్ టాటర్సాల్తో కలిసి సెయింట్ ఫిలిప్ చర్చ్కి వెళ్ళారు. డూ యూ థింక్ హీ హ్యాస్ నాట్ పెయిడ్ ఇట్, వాజ్ ఇట్ ఓవర్ డ్యూ, అంటే కట్టలేదా ఇప్పుడు మనం ఫైన్తో కట్టాలా. మిస్సెస్ స్లేటర్, ఐ షుడ్ think it was overdue, ante fine tho manam kattal anukunta anani andi evaru mrs jordan.